Hello there, this is Lynn Allen. Welcome to another AutoCAD tip courtesy of Cadalyst magazine. Today I come to you from Sydney, Australia, where I've been fortunate enough to participate in the Autodesk University Extension. And today we're going to talk about kind of an obscure feature inside of AutoCAD that very few people know about it, but you're gonna find out about it. All right, that is the nudge feature inside of AutoCAD. That's right, nudge, nudge, wink, wink. Those of you who are cool will get that. So the nudge feature allows you to move objects on the screen without using your mouse at all, just by using the arrow keys, without having to go into any command at all. Let me show you what I mean. So taking a look at the screen, you can see that a couple of these poly arcs are definitely not in the right location. So I'm going to select them. Now, I could go into the move command. There are a bunch of different ways I can actually use grips to move these objects, but I'm going to hold down my control key, and I'm going to use my arrow key to move them around. You're probably saying to yourself, what distance is it moving those two poly arcs? The distance, which is kind of interesting, is 2 pixels. Not exactly a form of measure that we're used to working with, right? 2 pixels on your screen could be different than mine, depending on the resolution and so on and so forth. So you probably don't want to use it just like this with no control, unless you're just trying to move something around that doesn't need to be precise. In some cases, like text or something like that. So it's easy, it's fast, it's efficient. But if you go into the snap command and you have the snap set to something that makes sense in your drawing file, I'm going to change the snap and I'm going to set it to like 10, for example, and then make sure it's on, of course. You can do that any way you want to. Now let's try it again. Let's go ahead and grab those 2 poly arcs again. That guy, that guy. All right, now when I hold on my control key and I use the arrow keys, you can see now it's dramatically moving more than it did before. It's following the snap, and I have a little more control over it. So if I'm moving objects around, I don't know if I'm going to go to all this trouble, objects that need to be in a specific location. If I'm moving something around, like I said, text or something that's really where you're more eyeballing it on the screen, do this. It's fast, it's efficient, it's easy, it's very low stress, especially when you need to just nudge something a little bit. And we've all been there, right? All right, so thank you for joining me. I hope that you find the nudge tip a little bit helpful, and I hope to see you back here in 2 more weeks. Thank you for joining me.